Welcome back. We're now on to part two of the Tormented Demon. And just to keep talking about what I was mentioning at the end of part one there, with anatomy and using reference, I'd compiled a lot of reference prior to doing the initial sketches for this character. And it was my anatomy books. The picture of Christian Bale I mentioned, as well as some other things like pale skin, amputated limbs, and some other stuff that would lend itself well to a horror character. And as you can notice on the video, I don't actually have any of the reference visible as I'm painting. And the reason I do that is I find it a little bit distracting to have the reference right there. It's a little bit too easy to copy directly from it. So I like to usually study it beforehand, or to have it in a book away from the computer, just so I can glance at it and just make sure that what I'm doing is correct for the character. It's how I want it to look, and look somewhat realistic. But I don't want to just copy something, straight from a page or straight from a photo from the internet. So I'll just study it beforehand, and then when I get into the painting process, I don't even really open those images up. If I need to go back, I'll go back and look at them separately. To get an idea of what I need to do next. So now with the painting, it's mainly into that detail stage. The brush has shrunk down quite a bit, and I'm zooming in a lot more, and really concentrating on the details of this character, as well as blending in some of the leftover line work that you can see on the arm there, as I think most of the other parts of the body have already blended the line work in pretty well. And speaking of, I mentioned the amputated limbs reference. One of the ideas I had for this character was I also wanted to steer away from the cliched idea of the big demon feet or feet like a brute character would have. And I was just walking along the street. I think I was heading out to the shop somewhere, and just considering what I could do with this character that could be different. And I thought of this idea of him having like no feet, like almost stumps for instead of feet. And that led to the idea of maybe this guy, just following along from the whole idea that he's a tormented demon, and he's been tortured as like since he's become a demon. And I had this idea that maybe his feet had been cut off, and in place of his feet, some additional limbs had been sewn on. But just to rub salt into the wound of that is that those limbs are also amputated, so he still has to walk on these grisly stumps. And that idea also flowed into his arm, where I thought it would be cool if the reason why his arms are a little bit longer than humans would be is if the same thing had happened there, like a part of the arm had been severed off and replaced with someone else's arm, or it could even be a lower, the lower leg. And you won't see it in the video. I went back after I'd finished this video and just did a couple of extra adjustments to the character, and added some extra scarring around some of the fingers and around the stomach area, just to make it look like this guy had been. He'd been torn apart and pieced together, and maybe a few other demons had been torn apart at the same time, and the parts he got back weren't his own. And yeah, it's that whole idea. It's just something really grisly. It's one of the worst things I could think of for this character, short of painting him with his entrails exposed and hanging out, because that kind of thing doesn't really appeal to me so much. So I try to steer away from painting truly grotesque and graphic images. As you might notice, coming towards the end of the video, we're not there yet, but you'll notice that I've kept some of the original sketch, and I haven't detailed much of the other leg of this character. The main leg that's in focus is in full detail, but the other leg I've left quite loose. And again, that's something that I've picked up from other artists such as Doug Chang. And when doing design work, it's always good to leave parts of the sketch or parts of the painting quite loose. And the people viewing it are pretty intelligent. They can tell what's going on, especially if it's if the legs are exactly the same as each other. And it almost invites them to take part in the painting, and they can kind of finish it off themselves in their mind. And I like that idea that you're not giving everyone all the information. Okay, this is adding some texture layer. And this is a photo I took of some raw meat. It was a poster of some raw meat up in a hamburger place I went to with my brother. And I thought the texture was just really gruesome, and I've been waiting to use it on a painting. I thought this guy, it's perfect for him. So I opened it up and set it to a clipping mask so that it only went inside what I'd already painted. It didn't affect the background at all. And then I set it to, I think, overlay mode and lower the opacity, and just erase the little sections that I don't like or don't want. And you can't really see much of the texture, but it does add something to the painting. It adds a little bit of extra color, and there's just a little bit of extra texture in there that makes it seem more like a traditional worker as opposed to a digital painting. It gets rid of some of that digital feel that you get from digital painting. And here, just really fleshing out the highlights and the details on the face there. The face and the chest area is the main selling point. Pretty much for any character design, you can actually do the rest of the painting completely loosely, and just indicate some details here and there, as long as you've got the chest and the face, up to scratch. People tend not to notice, because that's where you look when you're looking at a person. You look in their face, you look in their eyes. And if you see them from a distance, you'll usually see from the chest area up. So just adding in the small details such as veins and little pimples, which was an idea from my girlfriend, to give him some nasty pimples. And I'm about to start messing around with the background. I thought it would be a good idea to add in a rusty texture as the background. I thought that could be a good horror look, but there was just something about it. I couldn't get it the way I liked it, so I ended up scrapping the idea. I might have to work on it with another painting at a later date, because I still like the idea of a rusty background for a horror painting, but for this time I just couldn't get it the way I wanted it. And rather than just keep pushing it and getting to a point where I started to dislike the painting, I thought it would be just easier to scrap the idea and just try something new, which that never hurts either. So you can see I I really tried to save it, but yeah, just wasn't happy with anything that that was getting through. And you see now, I'm just about to scrap it. And I kind of like the darker image that was going there, so that led to my next idea was just to do a plain background with a little bit of a gradient. And I think I didn't end up using the gradient tool. I used the one of the custom cloud brushes I've got, or smoke brushes, and just painted in a little bit just to give the background some difference. And I end up doing a blood streak going down the left side of the page near the character's face. And I think that turned out better than the rust texture. Even though it's a character design and it's just on a blank background, it's not really an illustration or anything. It's more of a concept design. It's still a good idea to add a shadow, just to ground the character so it's not floating in space on the page. It just adds that little bit extra to the painting, and like I said, it just grounds it, makes it look a little bit better. It's a little bit easier on the eye. And I'm pretty much finished here, or at least I think I'm finished. As I mentioned before, I did actually go back and fix up little bits and pieces of the painting, but right now all I'm doing is I'm going through and cleaning up the edges of the image. Because he's still throughout the entire painting, I kept him separate from the background, and just cleaning up little bits here and there around the edges, and painting in some small miscellaneous details like darkening the shadows with an overlay mode, and darkening up some of the bloody areas. And one of the last things you'll see me doing here is, I'm using a color balance adjustment layer to just to give a little bit more life to the painting, make the shadows a little bit bluer. And that pretty much concludes this painting. I hope you've enjoyed it. As I hoped before that I hope you got something out of it. And please feel free in the comments section to leave me any questions and any suggestions of future paintings that you might like to see me tackle, or future subjects.